In recent time, Ghana tourism is being said to be one of the fastest growing industries in the country. But I'm also trying to find out from Ghanaians, where is their first point of contact? Should they want to embark on any trip?
I'll go online and then find out the exact place that I'm going. So I'll go to Google and then type where I want to go first. From there, look at the cost and then proceed.
Well, I normally Google. I like traveling. So I Google, I search the place, how it's far or near, the cost that will be involved. After that, then I check my account. If I have money, I go. If not, I stay.
However, there is an emergence of travel content creators in the country who are helping to boost the tourism sector. With their work mainly on the various social media platforms, it is becoming very competitive. But interestingly, a section of the Ghanaian populace have little knowledge of these travel content creators.
I am at one of the landmarks for every tourist who makes his or her way into the country, and that is the Kwame Nkrumah Museum, to meet up with a travel content creator to talk about travel content creation in Ghana, what she makes of the tourist industry, and even if there's a future for travel content creators.
Cindy Amwakon Nyama, popularly known on social media as CC Travels, tells me becoming a travel content creator was a perfect blend to starting her own business and exploring her passion for travels.
I have always been interested in aviation, so that was what I did. I went to the Ghana Civil Aviation School and I studied travel and tourism. From my travels and something, I felt like if I should start something on my own, people would connect with my own travels and then it would get them interested.
But just like every other venture, it is fraught with many challenges. She does not find it surprising that most Ghanaians have not heard of travel content creators.
It's costs involved, so it wasn't really easy. And then in the beginning, people were not really accepting that. People think the Americans and other people are the ones who do this travel content, but most of them don't know. There's a spring of content creators in Ghana.
Sisi believes it is about time that the Ghana Tourism Authority develop initiatives to support indigenous creators like herself.
It's their passion, they want to do it, but because they are not really getting any exposure, any support from the government, they feel like, no, then there's no need for me to, you know, go on and do this again. If we are to do this and then the tourism board, you know, posts something like this, or people know that, oh, the tourism board is, you know, part of this, I think they would rather appreciate more. They would know that they have a support, they have a backing.
Ghana is expected to host some 120,000 foreigners during the festive season, an opportunity to promote the country's tourism after the sector was badly hit by the coronavirus pandemic. Della Michelle, TV3, Accra.